Hi, in this video we're going to learn how to calculate percent yield. It's a four-step process. I'm going to take you through each step today. And the four-step process all begins with writing a balanced reaction. Now, a lot of problems, they're going to give you a balanced chemical reaction to start with, but sometimes you need to determine the balanced reaction yourself. So let's take a look at a hard example where that is the case. Gaseous ethane reacts with gaseous oxygen gas to produce gaseous carbon dioxide and gaseous water. 5.31 grams of carbon dioxide is produced by the reaction of 15.6 grams of ethane and 23.3 grams of oxygen gas. Calculate the percent yield of carbon dioxide. So in order to get started with this problem, like I said, you do need to write the balanced chemical equation. Before you can do that, you need to identify the reactants and the products. So based on the way the question is worded, we can see that ethane and oxygen gas react with each other, and that is going to produce gaseous carbon dioxide as well as gaseous water. Now, I've highlighted then the starting materials in yellow and the products in green. So now that we've identified those, we're going to go ahead and write out the balanced equation. So we'll start out just by writing down the chemical formulas of all the substances, reactants on the left, products on the right, and at first it won't be balanced. We'll balance it at the end. So we'll just plus CO2 plus H2O. Gas. All right, so now to balance it, we'll need to put a 2 in front of the CO2 because there's 2 carbons on the left and only 1 on the right. And next, to balance hydrogen, there's 6 on the left, so we'll need to put a 3 in front of H2O so that there are also 6 on the right. To balance oxygen, well, there's 7 on the right but 2 on the left, so we'll need to put a 7 halves in front of oxygen. And now it's balanced. Unfortunately, you know, we don't love fractions in our balanced equation, so we can multiply everything by 2, and that'll get rid of that pesky 7 halves fraction. It'll just become 7. Okay, and keep in mind as you're writing out this balanced chemical equation, you know, you can write the states gas, you know, but really that's extraneous information. We don't really care if the reactants are solid, liquids, or gases, so it's not going to affect your answer. So if you want, you could just leave out those little G's at the end of all the substances because it's not going to affect your answer. So there you go. I didn't even put H2O gas. Okay, so once you have the balanced chemical equation, the next step is to determine what is the limiting reactant. To determine the limiting reactant, what you'll need to do is calculate the molar masses of the reactants. That's going to be key because I see we've been given amounts of reactants in grams, but chemical reactions don't work on gram ratios. They work on mole ratios. So we'll need the molar mass of all the reactants. To find the molar mass, simply multiply the atomic mass of each element present in the compounds by the number of those elements. So for example, in C2H6, we have 2 carbons. So to find the molar mass, we'll take 2 times the atomic mass of carbon, which is 12.011 grams per mole, plus 6 times the atomic mass of hydrogen, which is 1.008 grams per mole. And then if we do that math on our calculator, we'll find our answer is 30.070 grams per mole. And that's for ethane. That is the mass of 1 mole of ethane in grams. Now we'll need to repeat this process for the oxygen gas. We'll need to find the molar mass of that. The process is exactly the same. So to find the molar mass of oxygen gas, what we'll do is we'll multiply 2 by the atomic mass of oxygen, which is 15.999 grams per mole. We do that on our calculator. We get 31.998 grams per mole. Beautiful. Once we have this information in hand, solving for the limiting reactant is relatively straightforward. We'll start by copying down the amount of ethane that was provided to us. So if you look up in the question there, we see that we do have 15.6 grams of ethane. We'll start by copying that down. And now what goes up must come down. So we can convert that into moles. So if we put 1 mole ethane on the top, and our 30.070 grams ethane on the bottom, if we multiply that together, the grams of ethane cancel and we end up in moles of ethane. And now we can convert the moles of ethane into the moles of CO2 product that is formed. And we can use the balanced equation coefficients to do that. So we can see in the balanced equation above, there's 2 moles of ethane for each 4 moles of CO2 produced. So we can use that as a conversion factor. And if we multiply everything together, we get an answer of 1.04 moles of carbon dioxide. Okay, now we need to repeat the process for the starting quantity of oxygen gas. So we have 23.3 grams of oxygen gas. Again, we'll need to first convert that into moles. So 1 mole of oxygen gas is equal to, and we look at our molar mass above, 31.998 grams per mole. Okay. Our grams of oxygen cancel, we end up in moles of oxygen. Then we can again use the coefficients in our balanced equation above. That's why it was so critical to write that balanced equation. We can see now that 7 moles of oxygen go on to react to form 4 moles of carbon dioxide. And if you multiply that all together, you'll end up with 0.416 moles of carbon dioxide. Okay, now we can determine the limiting reactant. It turns out that the starting quantity of oxygen that was given produces less carbon dioxide than the starting quantity of ethane that was given. What does that mean? That means that oxygen was indeed our limiting reactant. And that's critical because we need to determine the percent yield based on the amount of product that's formed from the limiting reactant. So we've identified now the limiting reactant, and that's step two to solving our percent yield question. The next step is finding the theoretical yield of this reaction. So let's do that. To find the theoretical yield, what we'll need to do is convert the moles of CO2 expected to be produced by our limiting reactant back into grams. So let's examine only the product of interest. Now, you may be wondering, why did we calculate the moles of CO2? Well, if you look up above in the problem, they ask us to calculate the percent yield of carbon dioxide. That's why we're focusing on carbon dioxide here. So our product of interest is carbon dioxide. Now we can find the molar mass of carbon dioxide. That will be critical for us in determining the theoretical yield in grams. The molar mass of carbon dioxide is found just like usual. We'll take 1 times the atomic mass of carbon, which is 12.011 grams per mole, plus 2 times the atomic mass of oxygen, which is 15.999 grams per mole. And if we do all that math up on our calculator, it's always good to have practice doing this on your calculator, you're going to get 44.009 grams per mole. That's the atomic, it's the molecular weight of carbon dioxide, also known as its molar mass. So now that we have the molar mass of carbon dioxide, and we also have the moles of carbon dioxide expected to be produced by our limiting reactant, we simply copy down the moles of carbon dioxide that we would have from our limiting reactant, which is the 0.416 moles, then use our molar mass of CO2 to convert that into grams. So what goes up must come down, so moles of CO2 are on the bottom, and we can convert that into grams by writing the 44.009 grams of CO2 on the top. When you multiply all that together, you get 18.3 grams of CO2, and that is indeed our theoretical yield of carbon dioxide. That is a theoretical maximum amount of carbon dioxide that could be produced if you combined 15.6 grams of ethane and 23.3 grams of oxygen gas. That's the absolute maximum that you could make. We call that the theoretical yield. Almost done. The last step, once we find the theoretical yield, is to simply calculate the percent yield. Let's go ahead and do that. To calculate the percent yield, you'll need to know the formula for percent yield. And the formula for percent yield is as follows. Percent yield equals, drum roll please, the actual yield. Now the actual yield is not something that you can calculate. It's something that must be given to you. And in the problem above, you can see that they did give us a yield of carbon dioxide. And that actual yield is going to be divided by the theoretical yield that you just calculated. And of course, because this is a percent yield, don't forget to multiply by 100%. The units of percent yield are always in percent. So the actual yield that's given in the problem above is 5.31 grams carbon dioxide is produced. And then our theoretical yield that we just computed above is 18.3 grams of carbon dioxide. So we'll do that division, multiply by 100%, and we get our final answer, which is 29.0%. So that's it. That's how you calculate percent yield in a question like this. We'll just go ahead and label this as our percent yield, and now you know all 4 steps to solving a problem of this difficulty.